lane of the Chiefs from last split, carrying into split number two. Maokai banned away from Porky. That's an interesting ban by the Chiefs.
Yeah, it certainly is, especially because Swiper plays it so well, so not wanting that one to get through. Porky is a player on Avant for me. I just think he's their superstar. Like, you can agree or disagree, but this guy is the most solid player probably in the OPL. He really is just that good, and he plays absolutely everything. So I'm surprised they throw a ban at him.
Yeah, I mean, Maokai, as you said, it's a big Swiper champion. A Bard ban, our first in the OPL, I believe. It's clearly some homework being done here on E-Gym, because that was not what they were playing last day one. Rek'Sai the ban there as well. Very strong jungler, Chelvy's specialty especially. But Porky's got his pick at the top lane, so is he going to go for Hecarim? That's the big starting question.
Yeah, I would like to see him pick something like that up, try and shut down Raidir through a different lane. But let's hit on it for a second. He's OP. He is so strong right now. I have no idea how other teams are not picking him up. His CC is ridiculous, like a 4-second cooldown late game. He does damage as soon as you get some chimes. And his ultimate is literally an Omwrecker slash like stop dragon slash stop Baron, like I'm going to fight you now tool that is really hard to dodge.
Yeah, I mean, a little bit slow on the missile speed, got good long range as well. A great team for ultimate if you can use it effectively. And took a couple patches, but players finally figuring out how to play Bard. Alistar, though, is the support first pick there for Avant. Love that as well.
Yeah, I am so not surprised. E-Gym already showed how good he is on the cow. Let's see whether Destiny can really pick it up to the same effect, because as we said, it's that free tank can get you a couple of rounds of spells out. And on the current tanky patch, you just can't afford to do that.
No, Cinderhawk's already making everyone tanky. Alistar ultimate doesn't help the mix, as well as Swiper continuing to flash the Tryndamere here, but Spooks gonna hover something a bit more realistic here, you have to think. With Rek'Sai banned, Gragas, even with her unbanned actually, maybe becomes the best first pick, and it's Nautilus Gragas there, the first two.
Yeah, exactly right. So Gragas being picked up, I like seeing Spooks play Gragas, because for a little bit of a background, he thought Gragas sucked when it was first in the meta, but now obviously coming through as the best jungler. Nautilus in the bottom lane, kind of the second tier of awesome supports. I really think Alistar is by himself at the moment at the top of that. So we'll see whether E-Gym can play it as well as what he was playing the Alistar.
I mean, we've seen Chuffer play it hyper aggressively. Trash Boat was nice and controlled, but with calculated aggression. E-Gym, big playmaker, loves his Silk champions. I'm sure Nautilus is right up there as well. But Avant, couple picks coming through. And I think what you said about Porky is really interesting here with the Maokai ban especially. Swipe is a big tank player, okay? He's got his two Tryndamere. He can open up, but on this team especially, sort of pigeonholed into just playing tanks. Porky's much more versatile, like you said. He's got the Rumble, got the champions like the Hecarim. He's even got Lissandra from, you know, a couple patches ago back at the start of the season that he can run to as well. But Avant, looking over the next few champions, we saw in the last game, actually swaps away from Hecarim, but it's Rumble Jinx is their second and third.
Yeah, so he's got his Rumble up there, and we'll see how that one works out. He is a very good Rumble player in his own right, but I feel that now Swiper can just take the Aurelia. And that is a very easy lane matchup to navigate if you are the Aurelia player. So I think a little bit of a misstep here. And, you know, we mentioned the Twist of Fate in the pregame. Would not be surprised at all if that went through.
No, it's a contested pick between these two. Kensty, known for a bit, Swift for a big Twist of Fate player as well. For me, with the Rumble pick, just going back to it, it's extra weird for me because Maokai is still not available, actually. Rumble's probably at his best in the Maokai matchup, but that's never going to happen here for Porky.
Yeah, exactly right. So maybe he's thinking a Sion might come out and he can weather that storm. That will not be locked
in because
Swiffer does not play it and Kensty does play it. I think that is a little bit of homage coming through there, but I wouldn't be surprised to see Raidir pick up something like the Lucian, and he does.
I like the Lucian. I like the Hecarim there as well, Swiper. We kind of, you know, put him in a box there as a tank player. Has branched out. It's capable of doing so, but just needs to be a big tanky initiator for his team, and Hecarim fulfills the same sort of role.
Yeah, and I'm interested to see how he plays it here because I actually haven't seen him play Hecarim recently, but from what I have seen, he really was more of a Shyvana player. He really liked the Smite Teleport Shyvana coming through there, and that was his go-to champion. So we'll have to see whether that does transfer across to something like a Hecarim. Still a similar kind of champion where you can dive the carries. And I think this is being dictated a lot by the fact that Avant picked up that immobile AD carry. Hecarim is just such an easy response to Jinx right now because you can actually ult over the Chompers, and she has a very hard time to get away from you.
Yeah, you just ult straight on top of her and there's nothing you can do. So I agree, I like to pick a lot. I feel like Jinx needs to maybe be hidden in certain situations where you're not going to get it immediately, but Destiny's hovering quite the champion there. Sejuani did make it late through the picks as well, so wouldn't be that surprising. Sejuani's going to be the pick here, but Kensty, we talk about throwback champions, he's got Ziggs in the mid lane.
Yeah, I have a very strong personal opinion on Ziggs that I will not share on stream, but It's an interesting pickup. Stalls games very well. They have a hyper-scaling comp there with the Jinx. Ziggs does ridiculous amount of damage with Luden's Echo and a Lich Bane late game. He's also very quick because of the movement speed on both the items, and he likes to build them. You pick up like Alacrity as well, and you just zoom around the map. Really fun to play at the moment. Very annoying to play against. As well as something like the Sejuani that's going to keep all this people in place for the big AoE wombo to come through. Rumble, Ziggs, the Jinx. That is a lot of damage if they can hold them together.
Yeah, it's all zone control here from Avant here. They've got lots of displacement, lots of just things you don't want to walk through between Rumble ultimate, into Sejuani ultimate, and of course through the Ziggs minefield. So got a lot of protection in a weird way for this AD carry. And Warble, we talked about him, a big up-and-coming player here in the OPL. Gonna have to go off here on Jinx against Lucian's Raid is very competent, Lucian.
Yeah, exactly right. That's a terrifying bottom lane. And wow!
Victor.
Victor being shown here from Swiffer. So a little bit of a different champion being picked up. Victor does a heck of a lot of damage. Like, to just put it really simply, what does Victor do? He controls a little bit of zone, has some good kite potential, but all in all, the laser with the ultimate, just ridiculous AoE damage.
Yeah, very short, medium range mage, though. So you have to kind of get in your opponent's face, but Chiefs have plenty of setup for that Victor to go off. And you see Hecarim ultimate hit on a couple of people. Victor's going to be right on top of them, exploding people.
Yeah, exactly right. And once again, they've got the Jinx, they've got the Ziggs, these two champions that you can actually get to relatively easily. So if they can navigate the front line, I actually now would really have liked to see Porky on a tanky top laner and not ban them out. Well, that's why they probably banned them out by the way, but something much tankier, because you've got the Sejuani, you've got the Alistar. All of a sudden, if you can't get through them to the two backliners, that's a really good team comp coming out of AV. They've gone for a little bit more damage, but Chiefs have matched it relatively well.
Yeah, Nawa's open as well, actually. So you can almost pick it to block the Hecarim as well. Could have picked the Hecarim for yourself as well. I think I agree. Porky's definitely the star of this team. So a champion that Rumble does a lot of damage, can make a lot of plays, but maybe not necessarily the role play you need him to be in this team comp.
Yeah, exactly right. And you know, top lane is such a focal point right now because you kind of win top lane and win the rest of the match, because if you unlock your top laner, we saw it with Minky Whale, like there's just no response to these huge top laners at the moment, but Rumble isn't that kind of top laner. He really is more of a utility guy, does a heck of a lot of damage, don't get me wrong, but just isn't going to put the same amount of pressure down as Swiper is.
And some curious drafts on both these teams, so get on Twitter though and let us know who you think may have outdrafted their opponents. Use the hashtag AVWin or hashtag CHFWin for Avant or the Chiefs.
Yeah, so we'll have to see exactly who can pull it off. A lot more of a short range composition coming out of the Chiefs. They're going to struggle to siege turrets. Like, that's something that we just have to throw out in the open. Victor as well as Lucian, very, very short range, and the rest of the people on the team are melee. So that is one win condition already coming through from AV. You have to say that their team, very good at wave clearing. They've got a Ziggs. He's probably going to stall the game till about 3 hours. So they're going to have a hard time getting into the base. So neutral minion control to me is where the Chiefs win or lose.
I mean,
maybe
they just like play their 3 hour game and then hope like someone disconnects.
Yeah.
Run out the pause timer. That's the strat.
Run out the pause timer.
You never know. I mean, thank God there's no mobile League of Legends, because people would be running out of battery with Ziggs in the game.
Exactly right. So, like, honestly, if they are going to win this game, they need to do it in a way in either laning phase is the first thing. You can just crush teams in laning phase, or they need to get ahead in dragons, because otherwise AV's team comp's just going to take them late and beat them.
Yeah. I mean, we've seen a lot of scaling comps. I think last game was an example of the late game comp getting ahead early, and that's still an option here as well. But for me, the Chiefs have so much experience with Jinx. I want to see how they play against it, especially with Swiffer's Victor pick.
Yeah, I'm really interested about that as well, because that is something that we have to hit on, the fact that they don't really have that huge carry now for Raidir. He's going to be on a much more mid-game focus, and really, if the Hecarim gets over, it might be able to solo out the Jinx, but a lot of the pressure is on Swiffer to either delete Kensty, which I'm sure he'll be happy to do, or try and get on Warble, who has already shown that he's got really good positioning.
Yeah, and actually, Swiffer's got Ghost, I believe, on the Victor as well, so I love the double mobility summoners there coming in. We talk about it already, Victor, really short range when it comes in, has lots of movement options when he's in that short range, can use the Q for the power transfer and get a bit more speed going. We see a lot of them build Fuhrer boots, actually, when Victor's getting a lot of play. Alacrity's fine as well, just again to get more movement speed. You do need to zip around the map and really get in range of your targets, because you get in close range of people, constantly throw out lasers and Qs and get in range for your ultimate. People, they really do just die.
Yeah, and Victor's another dude that you can actually build like fourth or fifth item Lich Bane, make him go a little bit quicker, but also get the Q auto attack empowered and just delete people. Look for the way you generally play Victor is if you go for a poke build, you kind of sit back, kite, poke out. I don't think he can play that way just because of the fact that AV is a team that want to poke out with the zap as well as all the rockets that will come through. So Swiffer needs to look for a wall to be able to flash over, get all of his abilities off, and then run the heck away. And that's what the Ghost is used for.
Yeah, and look, the rest of your team can support him there as well. And Spooks, it almost always falls into the jungler's hands early on. But that's the reason we don't see Spooks play that much Sejuani. He can play the champion, I guess, just fine. Maybe a bit average as far as the OPL jungle talent on the champion goes. But he doesn't really like it that much. We've seen him punish the champion on the likes of Elise, even on other champions like Gragas. So I like when Spooks is on a high-pressure jungler. And that's one of the things that makes Gragas so obnoxious. Very tanky, very sticky, and so good early.
Yeah, and you know, you hit it on the head. A lot of the Chiefs' game plan is actually to let Spooks get their team ahead. Like, he's their shot caller in the early game. Like, Swiffer takes over as the game progresses, but they demand that Spooks come to lanes, and he's a very good jungler. If you put him on the likes of Sejuani where he has to farm, I feel that teams can nearly punish him too hard. And a lot of teams have figured out that pre, like, 12 minutes, Spooks is the key to beating the Chiefs.
Yeah, and that's why I like to pick a Gragas. We saw in his Lee Sin way back in the day, he's sort of fallen out of the meta. The champion, at least, has not Spooks. He's still here. And Gragas is a fitting replacement for that sort of jungler. We've seen people replace him as well. I guess Carbon was the biggest difference for me. Somehow managed to play Lee Sin-style aggressive on Sejuani, but crazy playstyles aside, Spooks is a player that really does benefit from high-pressure junglers.
Yeah, he certainly does. And Gragas does ridiculous amounts of burst damage early game. His W is so strong, and not to mention the Q. Very, very high damage comes out of Gragas.
Yeah, great stuff. We'll have to see what happens in our last game of the evening, though. Avant taking on the Chiefs, two of our top teams from last split as well. The Chiefs finished first in their last season. They're at 1-0 right now. See if they can get to at least 2-0 and stay undefeated for the week.
Yeah, we'll have to see whether they are going for another close to undefeated season.
13-1 last season. 4-0. Rip the dream.
Rip the dream.
Look, yeah, 4-0 got in there. Couldn't even get themselves back into the OPL, unfortunately. But we're in just long enough to upset the Chiefs, as we can see. Stacked up as 5, some deep trinket wards going to go down. But good response from both Porky and Kensty, going to get the counter wards down as well.
And I want to see what Chiefs do with this, whether they're looking for the 2v2 lane or whether they are actually using this time to work on their 2v1 strategy, because something at IWCI that we found out about the Chiefs is that they do not lane swap well.
I mean, it makes sense. They've got such strong laners here. I mean, Swiffer always going to be a strong laner, almost always isolated in the mid lane, but Swiper loves to take advantage of his lane opponents and get ahead of them in little ways there on the top side. Radia loves to 2v2 people, especially when Rosie on the team. Not a lot changes when EGM joins the position there as well, but you can see Wobble and Destiny, that ward actually spots them. So a good bit of vision there for the Chiefs, but they are sitting back in their base waiting.
Yeah, and it actually looks like Radiant moving towards the top side of the map. So the Chiefs are initiating a lane swap. This is very... No, they're not.
They've spotted them now, so they're going to go back down. Really clever wards there from the Chiefs being put down, because they had plenty of vision, basically all along the bottom side of the base. So wherever they left, they're going to spot it. In fact, there's even another ward there as well.
Yeah, there certainly is. But now I'm a little bit disappointed, because I thought that they were going to try something new, but instead they're just going to stay the Chiefs that everyone knows and love. 2v2, very, very strong laners. See if they can get themselves ahead.
Yep, Shelby level 2 going to go over to his blue buff now as well. Again, Spooks might be able to punish their 20, but on the opposite side of the jungle, probably not there, as the Gragas gets a bit of help from his friend. Swiper takes away a camp as well, and all of a sudden, lots of action here at level 1 in the bottom lane.
Yeah, so they're trying to shove out as well as get some harass down with that Riptide, but Warble actually using the rockets to great effect, able to push Radiant and Aegean back under turret.
A bit of extra damage there, but a very devastating level 2 coming through, and the Chiefs move back in, zone them away. One creep left, I think. Good harass though from Radia coming in. And they need one more. No, make it 2 here. Need a bit more here to get to level 2, but this Olin's coming. Ejim already lining himself up here onto Destiny. Great Riptide coming through. Radia trying to clean up the creeps. There's the level 2. Warble gets hooked. Instant pulverize from Destiny, and good Chompers to keep himself safe.
Yeah, they hit it simultaneously because Warble was prioritizing creeps over Ejim there. They understood exactly what was going down. Chiefs wanted to play the level 2, but well warded off by Avant.
Bit too early there for the Chiefs. Good catch onto Destiny there with the passive from Nord. regardless, but Staggering Blow not quite enough. Warble keeps the essing, and after the level 2 action all in, probably going to see things slow down quite a bit.
Yeah, we certainly are. It's kind of like, all right, cool, you found us out. We're not going to really get much done, but Spooks, he's looking to get aggressive early.
Yeah, good early pressure here. Level 3, Swiper going to come through as well. Flash misses there, but Porky flashes instead. Slow does come through. Swiper going to move in. Good damage coming in for the trade, but bit of a miss flash there for Spooks as the trade comes back for Porky.
Yeah, he just needed to walk at him. He was behind him.
Yep.
That was weird.
I think he really wanted to catch him with the Flash Body Slam, but maybe not quite as practiced on his list of mechanics as his Gragas mechanics.
Yeah, and the other thing is, like, just Body Slam first because you know how you're going to reach him.
Oh, Warble, though, gets hooked. Oh, great stuff from E-Gym. Calibrating those hooks very well once again, but almost know that Shelby's there. He's so low actually going back. Probably not helpful in the dive if it happened, but Warble and Destiny still safe.
Yeah, Shelby was the opposite of helpful because, like, you catch a piercing light and all of a sudden the laner has double buffs. That's not what you want to give away. So he goes back in shock. As we see Swiffer, he's trying to zone Kensi now out of this lane, even CS, but trying to get aggressive.
This is so important, I feel like, with short-range mages, especially melee champions when they come up in the lane as well. If you can somehow pull the creep wave on your side and keep it there, you can just bully out these, okay, very poke-heavy, wave-push-heavy mid lane. What's Ziggs going to do in a situation when he's getting zoned? All he does is push.
Yeah, exactly right. And the thing about Ziggs bombs is they don't clear out by themselves. You actually need items to clear out the back line. So unless Kensi wants to use two spells for it, Swiffer can hold the lane here for as long as he wants.
Yeah, unfortunately, Swiffer ate a Q, so a bit of that work being undone there as Kensi will eat his potions and be back to safety. But again, Swiffer keeping the lane in a nice spot, not letting Kensi dictate, and a very nicely angled laser gives him a bit more harass.
Yeah, that's hard to do, walk forward and laser sideways, so he's showing that he's got the victim mechanics down pat there. I actually checked his match history before the game, and he hadn't had a Victor game in there, so he's hiding something from us somewhere, but he's playing it very well.
Yeah, Swiffer always has champions in his back pocket, it feels like, but back in the bottom side now. Radiant decently doing decently well on CS. Warble actually about 10 behind here, but this is sort of what we expect in this sort of aggressive lane. Lucian so good at bullying in the early stages, and this is one of the few lanes where Jinx just has to sit back and let it happen.
Yeah, certainly, and Destiny needs to help him pick up some CS here because he hasn't gone back in shop yet. We'll be in about 5 CS touching distance, so that's completely fine. Lucian does lose some range, and that's something that you can't buy in the shop. Very important to point out. Warble, you just missed 4 CS. That's sad.
That is sad stuff. And Shelby coming down as well. Might be able to turn the tide to the lane here. Another CS going off the turret. Kind of rare to see players miss CS like this, especially with the Targons coming in for Alistar. But Spooks takes away the Scuttlecrab, thinks about Dragon, but just walks away back to his jungle.
Yeah, now maybe looking for the... Wow!
Good flash pulverize. Chomper's there as well. Actually waits for the CC chain to complete, and Radiant going to get ignited. Shelby flashes in, and that's first blood of Spooks. He comes down, but he's far too late.
What a flash pulverize coming through from Destiny. I want to see the replay to see if he actually pulverized first. Because if he did, they were some sick mechanics out of the support player.
Yeah, waiting for the Chompers to ignite there as well, and headbutted him while he was still snared. That was really well done by Avon.
Yeah, so they're able... Wow.
EGM eating another one there. Chompers down once again. Spooks now. Maybe the next one to get caught. There was a very odd-looking duo lens formed here by the Chiefs, but Radiant coming back. Got a pickaxe for himself, but Warble's going to go back with an even bigger buy. Is EGM going to go back in, but Destiny pretty tanky at level 5.
Yeah, he certainly is. They're just trying to dissuade them from getting a full shove so they can freeze it under the turret. They have got the freeze, so that's good news. But let's take another look. Does he pulverize flash? That is the question. No, he flash pulverized. Still a very good setup there.
Yeah, I mean, Trumper's coming in there. Destiny lets him trigger, and then Shelby's just there with plenty of flashes because Shelby's always there with a flash.
Yeah, exactly right. Shelby secures the kill for his team, gets his bottom lane back in the game. The assist means that a BF sword compared to a pickaxe now in the bottom lane. And we keep saying this about Jinx, but if she gets ahead, she's going to wreak havoc in the mid game.
Yep, much like every Jinx versus slightly short-range AD carry. This is going to be the problem. You get to level 5, 3 levels there in your switcheroo, so the rockets do a bit more damage, you get a bit more range, AD starts to scale up, and all of a sudden, all that bullying you were doing on the Sivir, on your Lucian, just for nothing now against the BF sword.
Yeah, exactly right. And the thing about mid-range carries, why they struggle so much about Jinx, is because when Jinx auto-attacks the caster creeps, you get hit by the splash damage. So you take so much inconsequential damage when you're just trying to CS. And that's not what Radiant wants to be about. He wants to be aggressive as EGM nearly gets caught again.
Yep.
And the Chief's now in a little bit of trouble in the bottom lane.
Yeah, I mean, keeping the lane in a decent spot here, trying to zone out some experience. This is one of the things that Alistar can't do that well, is actually break a freeze, because he has to get so deep in there, and without his ultimate, that's a bit dangerous. So the Chief's doing a good job to keep the wave where it is, and Radiant's actually up healthily in CS, but that will not last that long, especially as Warble gets more levels.
Warble dodges out the hook. That wave is pushing. So Avant, they're completely fine. Top lane, everything normal. And this has been a very slow early game out of the Chiefs and Avant.
But you can see Warble now trying to get some harass down, getting the last hits where he can. Wants the lane to push back, like you've said, because it is pushing back for them. Really going to get the hits where he can. If a heat level 6 might be going in, Warble gets hooked there. Great headbutt from Destiny. And some good chompers to zone as well.
Ooh, the zap hit as well. Radia took some damage in response. Not much happening in the mid lane.
No, mid lane's actually been surprisingly quiet. I mean, a bit of early zoning from Swiffer. He's actually got a slight CS lead still there, but, you know, keeping it relatively healthy there is Kenstein. Ziggs lanes, unfortunately, just kind of make the mid lane into a top lane.
Yeah, exactly right. And, you know, now he's got some AP and some cooldown reduction, so he can legitimately throw down Minefield as well as the Bouncing Bomb and take out every creep in the wave. Ziggs very fun to play against in that regard because he's very good at just, ooh.
Yep. Actually, culling is there from Radia, but just a couple, not even an ulti forced out there. Destiny actually only level 5, but protecting their pink ward very valiantly there, Aravant.
Yeah, but they managed to get the shove back in their favor, unless Radia keeps auto-attacking, which he is. So this is a weird bottom lane right now. Radia trying to get aggressive, but I don't think they have the item.
I mean, they want to hit 6 and all in, but Destiny is now level 6. I agree. I don't think they can force here at all. Radia probably going to start to fall a bit behind in CS as Wobble keeps control back of the lane. As we pop back in the top lane, been quite a lot of farming happening. Swiper doing a good job early, but an early Feiji is a curious first pickup here for me.
Yeah, so he's going with the Trinity Force first because he has the Ignite. And the thing that's confusing me... Ooh.
Yeah, that's actually not good ulti there. Chelby, though, waiting in the wings, looks to find the ulti. Spookso lining it up as well. Headbutt lands in there. That's a little too close. Spooks lands a flash body slam into ulti and 2 teleports down instantly as Wobble flashes out. Porky takes out Ejim though, now onto Radia as Destiny gets low, but Porky doing so much work. Swiper trying to come down, but Porky, massive damage, gets himself the double. Chelby might go down here as well, but Destiny keeps him safe. Takes out Gragas there on the Sejuani, kites away Swiper, and that's 4 kills for Avant.
Yeah, 4-for-1 in the bottom lane. Avant absolutely clean house, and that was all on the Rumble player. Zone 2 members killed another by himself and got so much damage down. Chiefs just kept trying to fight for no reason.
And that's the second counter gank from Chelby that's yielded some very nice fruits. Turret goes down there as well. And let's watch that again.
Yeah, so they go in. Once again, they just keep engaging. This time onto an Alistair who's so tanky. They think they have Warble, but Chelby, perfect timing. They overcommit, not able to get him. And look at Porky on the back line. Singles out the support, then turns around, zones Radia, is zoning Swiper already, who's on the backside, and just gets so much damage down on absolutely everyone. That was just a freakishly good play coming out here, and Spooks, he was caught between two bad places. Do I try and help Swiper clean it up? Do I get out? Chiefs do grab the dragon, but that's a 3,000 gold advantage already.
Yeah, sneaky dragon there for Chiefs. We'll keep them afloat here in this game, but ship. Starting to get a couple holes plugged in it there, actually. 5-1 now up for Avant, and I agree, great teleport there for Porky. A fine one to follow for Swiper, but mid lane is not involved, means that Avant has played a bit better. And I think the other thing for me, just watching that back, Radius target selection, he just couldn't decide who to shoot there.
Yeah, that's the problem with Lucian, you know, he's too short range, and the Jinx, she has the luxury of being able to just target whoever she wants because she fires so far, not to mention her ultimate is much more useful in that situation as an execute, so completely agree, it was just not the right fight for the Chiefs to take.
And for me, I'm not too sure who's showing up to this game because it's quite a reserved Chelby that we've seen so far. The first flash just secure the kill and read it. Okay, bit more aggressive, but he's actually just counter gank. He peeled for his AD carry there as well with his Sejuani ultimate. He's a very different player who used to play Lee Sin only.
Yeah, exactly right. You know, this is the second time in a row that we've said that about Chelby. He's had a very reserved start to the season. I think he only died one time the first game. I was like, what the heck is going on?
I mean, certainly grew to be a much more all-round player, I think, in their win, especially for Avant in that last year, at the end of last year. But Kensi now in trouble. Spook's going to knock him up. Swiffer, massive ulti, and that's the damage that Victor does.
Yeah, exactly right. And you know, the Chiefs, they were trying other things. Let's see if we can get Radia ahead. We'll go with a teleport strategy. Just gank Swiffer's lane. They've done it so successfully for years, able to pick another one up.
Ejim could be in trouble, gets headbutt pulverized by Alistar. Chelby gonna chase in the chompers land. Ult down for Jinx. Radia trying to cut them away. Destiny pops his ulti, but nobody's following that tower dive.
Yeah, so no turret dive coming through. A lot of damage going down in mid lane. Maybe an overcommit from Avant. They do get Ejim very low, but Swiffer still picking up CS in the mid lane, and I really think that that is the next focus coming through from AV because they need to shut down that strategy very very quickly.
Yeah, blue buff now going to get donated over. Spooks lining up the steal. Hecarim been called down here as well. And Swiffer just going to wait in range. Going to take a little bit more time. In fact, Bob comes through. Spooks does secure it, though. But at least they got it away from Ziggs.
Yeah, so they get it away from Ziggs. Ooh, maybe Swiffer caught out.
Yeah, could be in trouble there. Gravity Field goes down there. Box off Destiny, but Shelby gets the first knockout. Porky, great ulti there coming in. Shelby gets knocked forward, takes out the kill. Spooks not quite there with the Gragas ulti.
Yeah, that was a unique Gragas ultimate, but in the end, a very good equalizer secures the kill over there, and now mid-siege has been reversed. They're going to be able to chunk through this, and no response means they might actually get two.
Itarith's dead hand. Two is the problem here. Warble gets excited, does have some good flat AD going here. Raidir trying to trade in the bottom side. We'll get that turret, but if Chiefs lose another turret here, not worth it as far as trades go.
Yeah, exactly right. Don't race Jinx. She's just better at this point in the game, and they're able to grab the two turrets for it, as we mentioned, and now Egypt, he needs to make something happen.
Yeah, I mean, Destiny, I'd say in trouble, but he's got so many members of his team there that Ejim thinks about the hook and then wisely decides not to go back in. Raidir does push the wave into the other turret here, so we'll deny a bit of CS away, but he's going to go back, spend a bit more gold. He's got about the same items here as Jinx, but that's bad news for the Lucian player. You're supposed to be ahead at this point.
Yeah, exactly right. In every key metric of this game, AV is winning. They're up in turrets, they're up in gold, they're up in kills. Only thing the Chiefs have got going their way is dragons. With all honesty, if this game gets to fifth dragon, their team comp I think is actually weaker because of the fact that there is a Jinx and a Zig on the other side. So they really need to get a move on, and being able to siege down these outers and starting the hectic team fights we said in the champion select.
The nice thing is though, they actually are getting to some good timing. So Lucian goes back, he's got almost all of his Infinity Edge done, so he's quickly on the way there. Swoop is upgrading that Hextech. I can't remember the name, but
Hexcore.
It is the Hexcore, thank you. Upgrading the Hexcore nicely there as he takes away the blue and got his Abyssal Scepter completed already. And Swiper is rushing for a Trinity 4, so it's very mid-game focused for the Chiefs, but there's a very clear convergence point for this team comp where they're going to hit, you know, maybe 18, 20 minutes, and they're just going in.
Yeah, the problem is if they actually don't create things to fight over, it's very easy for Avant to wait them out, play their game, and just wave clear. So I really think that at this point they need to try and open up the map. It's just so hard to do against the Ziggs.
Yep, and the Rumble. I mean, this, again, a lot of zone control, lots of big AoE coming in. Swiver's going to try and keep the lane in a decent spot, but Chobi clearing out some wards. Dragon's back in a minute 30. That's not the worst time for the Chiefs to fight. IE is completed now for Lucian, but Swiper not going to be quite yet there yet. Swiffer will have a bit more, but not that much more as far as his item build goes. And Porky's already got to Leandries, so again, the Chiefs have to pick a point relatively soon, but that next big obvious point to fight around the Dragon, they're probably going to miss that window.
Yeah, they might miss it actually, because you look at all the items that are coming through right now out of AV. You mentioned the double pen items coming through, as well as the spin upgrade into Leandries. Boots to an IE. Jinx is arguably the strongest AD carry with that because of all the attack speed she gets out of minigun form. Lucian does a very good job as well. It really depends on me whether Swiffer can get Boots too, because if he gets Boots too, I actually think he can nearly kill the Jinx outright. However, if he doesn't, I think he's lacking in a little bit of damage.
And it's just getting him in there that might be the other issue as well. We saw what happened to Ziggs when Spooks ganked in there. Just got disintegrated there by the Victor, but AV gonna push down Dragon up in 30 seconds now, and Raidir might even have to use his ulti for wave clear, and probably the other thing he has to worry about getting dived here.
Yeah, and Destiny could have honestly tanked that up and just kept a whole wave, but we'll see whether they can start a fight. No, deciding to back away. Now, no culling coming out of Raidir. They're in a very good position to just take the Dragon.
Yeah, Swiper also needs to maybe go back and shop here. He's probably got a bit of gold banked up. They both have their teleport, so top laners can join in here for this next fight. But Dragon is up now in 5 seconds, and Avant are in full control of the area.
Yeah, and Swiper's in that horrible situation. Does he go for the home guard boots for this fight, or does he finish off the Trinity Force? I actually don't know what's going to be more impactful. Gut feel is it is the home guard, and we'll see whether that is what he agrees with and tries to pick up before the fight.
I mean, you can see Swiffer backing there in the mid lane just to the left. I think Chiefs are going to try and buy a bit more time and maybe give Swiper a chance to shop. If they wait long enough, you might get both, which would be very ambitious from the Chiefs. But at this point, if Avant are pushing a lane, Chiefs are probably happy because they really want to wait for this Dragon.
Yeah, they really need the next Dragon fight to go in their favor. And you can see Porky, he's outright starting to win the top lane as well with those two items. So a lot of pressure now on the Chiefs. And Avant, they're not giving them the time. They've started it up.
Yep, no time at all here for the Chiefs. Swiper might just have to come down now. Spooks is actually on the wrong side of the map. And I think the Chiefs have decided to give up the Dragon, maybe take a turret. That's actually not the worst trade in this situation. They'll get the turret. A massive Ziggs ulti comes through. Cost them a lot of health, but they'll take it away.
Yeah, so they're able to pick up an outer, and actually, wow.
That was really sick from Porky. Spooks going to try and peel him off. Not quite enough. There is Swiffer actually around to the side, going to try and take a Porky, but caught out of position. Destiny Flash Pulverize going to headbutt him over, and that's the easiest kill that Kensi's ever been given.
And that was double mobility. Someone is burnt from Swiffer. Still couldn't live. Ran the wrong way. Wasn't able to get out of there. Another heads-up play from Destiny. And, you know, they were able to trade objectives, opening up the maps, a good thing for the Chiefs. But Avant still able to come out ahead.
I think Swiffer wanted to kill Porky and then force a 5v4 would still be just fine, even though both the ultis for those champions would be down. But couldn't get the kill. Porky surprisingly tanky with the scrap shield there and the rest of his team to peel. And Spooks, he's going to have to give this turret up as well.
Yeah, so they're able to pick up a turret in the top lane. All outers now down for the Chiefs. And, you know, a 3,000 gold advantage at this point in the game is really good news for Avant. They're consistently winning parts of the map.
And you know what? Still ahead about 3,000 gold. Now even in Dragons, taking those turrets down as well. Swiper finally has his Trinity Force, but unfortunately, there's no fight point now for him to use it in. And the Chiefs going to have to do what they did in their last series, actually. Take it back into the middle late game and just show off some more team fighting. Because I mentioned that the Chiefs looking for another undefeated start to their OPL. Don't forget that Avant are also.
Yeah, exactly right. So Avant, they're looking for a 2-0 start and taking down the Chiefs. What a confidence boost that would be for the team. See, Swiffer, he really is starting to get going. He's picked up a needlessly large rod for himself as well. Only 20 minutes into the game. He's got a couple of upgrades in that Hex Core as well. But I honestly, I just don't know how they start a winning team fight if this game gets past the 30-35 minute mark. There's just so much disengage, peel, and consistent damage that's going to come out of the AV lineup. They really are going to have to play the team fight phase brilliantly. They've done it in the past. Don't get me wrong. If any team can do it, it's the Chiefs. But everything just looking in Avant's favor.
It really is, and you sort of identified it earlier. Radia hanging out on the top side, trying to maybe sneak a turret away, but Porky not having any of that, and it's just lack of options here for the Chiefs. Their comp sort of stifled because they fell behind early. They can't clear turrets, so they don't have moves around the mid game to actually get picks or start team fights in the jungle. And Zig's just going to keep the game extended here. Avant just going to farm out until the next objectives come back up. And the Chiefs, they have to force something sooner rather than later.
Yeah, exactly right. And there's just nothing to force right now. They can't bait Baron because realistically, there's no way they can do it at all. And, you know, AV, they just have so many tools in this really tanky frontline that is Destiny and Chovy right now. Chovy is 3-0-3 and put his gold only into team fighting. He's got the side stone, he's got the lock of the Iron Solari built up, and he's looking like one of the shining stars right now. We mentioned Porky, but Chovy, when he plays well, is a very good player in his own right.
Yeah, quite polarizing as far as performances go, but when he's on, he's really on as far as just skill and general performance goes. Spooks gonna try and clear out a ward here as well. We'll actually keep their pink safe for now. Swiper just hard pushing in the bottom side, trying to commit to split pushing here. Chiefs gonna clear out their red. That's been stolen away by Avant by the looks of things. And Swiper, who'll create what pressure he can. He's not a good champion to do it, but Rumble's getting stronger towards that two item power spike as well. Jig's not getting any weaker at this stage. And even Kensti looking for, I think, a Luden's actually to join that Merlinomicon. So Avant, all they have to do is wait, pick up their two items and pick the next obvious fight.
Yeah, the build I like at the moment, as we might actually have a gank coming through onto Radia, is you go Luden's, grab yourself a Void Staff, grab a Death Cap, and then you get a Lich Bane. And all of a sudden, Ziggs, who's already incredibly hard to get onto because of frontlines, just does ridiculous amount of burst and siege damage, and very hard to deal with in the late game. Also has a really good skin out at the moment, Master Arcanist Ziggs.
It is really sweet. He's actually a wizard, which is always my favorite thing. Yeah. I know you like to point out Kensti. Going to go back though, got himself his Luden's completed now, so that wave clear, in case he didn't have enough before, he's got plenty now.
Also, the multiple spell rotations that's going to come out of Ziggs just going to hurt even more. The two-item power spike, probably the highest you can get currently out of AP items, just sitting in a very good position. And the whole of, like, this game's deteriorated rapidly because all of a sudden the Chiefs, this proactive team, has put the brakes on the game. And that was already Avant's game plan. So this game can sit like this for a very long time until Chiefs get desperate enough to try something.
Yeah, Avant, Chiefs, sorry, just playing into Avant's hands here as Kensti takes out the Raptor as well. You can see that wave clear from the Luden's, or I guess the jungle clearing there. Really strong stuff already. Swiper, again, going to get stronger, but not tanky at this stage. Might have one tank component, maybe two if he's farmed up enough, and he's got a decent CS score at this stage, but Dragon's back in a minute 15. It's already equalized, so maybe that's not even a snowball point, but the Chiefs need to pick a fight, and this next Dragon's going to be their chance.
Yeah, it's a fight point, and that's what they're looking for right now. If they can get the home guards finished, maybe get a good engage, they might be able to sneak it away. They're trying to clear wards around it, but it just looks like that at the moment, if you ran both teams head-on at each other and there was no outplay, the Ivana just stronger. So we'll have to see whether they even go for it, because Radiant, he's still in the top lane.
He is. I mean, he's been split pushing for quite a while here. Up in CS, still against Warble, but Jinx much stronger than Lucian as far as items go. And Silver goes back. He's actually got himself a death cap now. So as far as 5 points go, Chiefs really powered up to try and succeed.
I'm so surprised he went for it, because that's a really aggressive build. We talk about short range carries. Normally you see the Zhonyas come out because you get one spell rotation down in Zhonyas. But he recognizes right now that the game is about being able to kill Warble, is about being able to kill Kensty. So he's gone a build that will allow him to do that.
And it makes Chelby's early locker even better here in this game. You can see he's got the Warden's Mail prepped there with the double cloth armor, but knows he needed to make sure Swiffer was as irrelevant as he possibly could be at that point in the game, given that he was probably the next person they had to worry about, or maybe the last person they had to worry about here. Dragon's back up though, Ravana already there. Porky does have his teleport, Swiper can join in as well, but the Chiefs, oh, good bait here by Avant. But it looks like the Wolf Spirit might be spotting him, although that's not the Chiefs' Wolf. That one's very hard to tell, but I'm not going to start the track.
And once again, Chiefs give it up, so another objective seated over there. They're electing to try and farm this game out. And Avant, they're able to pick up their second Dragon of the game, so I think we're going to have another 5 minute left.
Yeah, we are. I mean, again, Avant are more than happy for this game to continue at this pace. They probably would have been fine just trading objectives or even losing a dragon or two and just getting their farm up. They're actually getting ahead on objectives and still keeping the game at a stalemate, despite the fact they do have a small gold lead here as well. Probably just fine as far as their game plans go. Porky's got his Zhonyas now. Phantom Dancer completed there for Warble. You know, we need a couple more items for these champions before they really feel confident in their team fighting, but that's not going to take that much longer here, especially if the game continues like this. And the Chiefs, they are putting so much faith in their ability as a team in their experience, because they're at this point basically all in on team fighting.
Yeah, exactly right. They really have said, we will go late game against you, which is against a Jinx as well as the Ziggs, a very terrifying prospect. And Porky, he's showing that he's got very good control over this Rumble as well, so it's an interesting choice. Like, as I said before, if anyone can do it, it's going to be the Chiefs.
Spook steals away the Scuttlecrab there as Destiny tried to get it away with a headbutt, but the Scuttlecrab was not interested. He actually re-aggroed and ran away. That was very funny. Radia going to go back. Phantom Dancer completed now as well. So items starting to come through. Spectre's Cal done for Swiper as well. Again, the Chiefs are getting stronger with Sol Ravant and team comp for comp. I think we'd rather be on Avant's side.
Yeah, that seems to be the recurring theme here, is that Avant is playing there. Game plan, and the Chiefs kind of missed their window. But, you know, there's a few things you have to point out. Hecarim going to get incredibly big. So that's one thing. He doesn't have to invest in Cinderhulk, which late game really is kind of a wasted item on Hecarim, because you really do want to have things like GA, a lot of health through like a Warmog, something like that, and he can really start ramping up. But he's going to get huge, and he might be able to delete someone. Swiffer, if he picks his moment, will delete someone. Look at his build already. He is going for the all-in of ridiculous amounts of AP. So they do have windows where they can fight. The problem is that you're going to have to run through a Sejuani, a Naren, and an Alistar to get through the only two people you really want to kill.
Yeah, and a Rumble ulti. And Porky's a threat late game as well, especially with the Zhonyas. Even at this point in the game, like, if the Chiefs' one job was just to kill this Jinx in the game, I think it'd be just fine taking it late, but there are so many threats. Even Sejuani is not bad in a late game situation as far as Northern Wind scaling goes. Like, the Chiefs have a lot of things to worry about here, and again, putting a lot of faith in their experience as a team to navigate what's going to be a very complex late game situation that they're opting into at this stage.
Yeah, exactly right. So we'll have to see whether they can pull it off. They are getting ahead in CS in every single lane, so that's one thing we have to point out. They're doing that incredibly well. They're actually minimizing the gold advantage purely through farming right now and rotating around the map. But this is what they need to worry about, because all of a sudden, Nirvana forcing.
Oh, Spook's going in. Great ulti onto Warble. Follows in from Medium's Death Charm, but Shelby just an ult there onto Spooks. They're going to keep going in. Trumpets go down. Destiny forced to pop his ulti. Spooks gets called back into the team, but everyone coming down. Now Porky going to join in. Hecarim diving on the back line. Takes out the Jinx Swiper. Going to rejoin the fight. Porky is so low, and Kensty, you are very late to your party, my friend. Shelby going to be the next target, and the Chiefs, we talked about them having to navigate wonderfully. That's three already. Swiffer, He's dead. Didn't even get to use his ultimate, but it's not going to matter. Destiny's going to be the fourth kill. Kesty almost gets hooked to make it five, but the Chiefs, a 4-for-1 victory.
And what good shot calling. Understood exactly when they had to fight. They had the inside lane because even though they had no control over their jungle, they had forced Kensty on the opposite side of mid of where he wanted to be. That was all they needed to hit the go button, and all of a sudden, this game completely even, but some gold going over to Swiper, and that is not the target you want to get going.
No, Spirit Visage up now as well. Swiffer continuing to upgrade his Hex score. Minions are pushing down the mid. We've got a top wave starting to mount there as well for the Chiefs, and we talked about their late game shot calling. What about mid game shot calling here? Is the team fighting and the call to go in there, just brilliant there. And this is why the Chiefs are such a hard team to beat in OCE.
Yeah, it certainly is. They actually understand when they can fight better than most teams. Even internationally, we're willing to make that call. The problem is that they delay a lot of the time when they are going to get in it losing situations. This time, they pull the trigger early and come up with something good.
I mean, it took a couple fights. They kind of just saw two dragons sail by to get to this stage, but Shelby going to clear out the Scuttlecrab, but he cannot face check this Victor. The Swiffer, I guess, is a bit worried about everyone else being there. Take out the Scuttlecrab, though, so Shelby, with his smite ups, going to get denied that. We'll clear out a ward for his trouble here, but everyone else getting stronger as Radia returning back with a BF sword now.
Yeah, and something we need to point out is, along with all the extra farm that the Chase has been willing to pick up, wow.
That's a big ulti there. Kensty getting chunked out. Doesn't quite go down. Does use his heal, though, to keep safe there. And Swiffer, we talk about the big spell rotations. He gets close enough and anyone will melt.
Yeah, exactly right. That was with no help from anyone. And what I was going to mention is actually exactly what happened. Level advantage is really coming through for the Chiefs right now. You see Spooks, he's two levels above Chelby. Swiffer, he's up in levels. Swiper, he's up in levels. Everyone's up in levels, and they've done it through purely rotating around the map and absorbing farm better than what Avan had.
I mean, they're ahead in gold now as Warble gets soloed there by Radier in a 1v2. Destiny actually has to run away because of how strong Radier is, and Zigzulti going to come through, but Radier going to ignore it. Porky, the next one to get jumped on. Shelby with a massive three-man ulti. Porky tries to cut them off, but Hecarim going to chase them down. Porky goes down. Shelby gets ulted back into the team. Swift is here as well. Shelby can't go anywhere else now on the Sejuani. This is going to get CC for days, and the Chiefs explode across the map. Three kills for nothing.
And the weird thing is they had vision everywhere of Avant. They must have seen that coming, but an outplay from Radia equals pressure on the other side of the map. And now all of a sudden, Chiefs 4,000 gold in the lead and exploding through the mid-game.
I mean, we said they had to snowball at some point. They picked maybe the latest possible opportunity to do so, but one team fight after another, this time across both sides of the rift, and the Chiefs now a 4,000 gold ahead.
Yeah, exactly right. And you know the scariest thing? I still don't know whether it's enough. Because eventually, AV are going to catch back up in kills. And we keep mentioning the lack of range. They still can't siege the inner. So this game, really, even though they've just done everything they can to drag their way back into it, it's still yet to be seen whether this is enough for the Chiefs to really take it over.
Well, they're going
to
equalize on Dragon, so that will help as far as objectives go. But Baron might be the next big thing here. If the Chiefs can force a fight, not even get the Baron, but just, again, force AV to come to them with their Ziggs and the rest of their long-range poke-style siege comp they're coming through. As long as they can force fights like that, and you look at the points where they force them, either on their own terms or in Avant's jungle, those are the fights that the Chiefs can actually win.
Yeah, exactly right. So we'll have to see whether they can continue to force. As Spook's trying to clear out vision around the Baron, that's another area that they can force a fight if they would like to. And
they would like to.
A lot of pressure just got transferred onto AV.
Yeah, I mean, AV now, we're playing, you know, a very controlled game, kind of chilling out. A couple, like maybe 1,000 gold ahead, 3,000 actually at one point, but the Chiefs kind of kept it closer to 2 with some strong farming and rotations. Now back up, exploding 4,000 gold ahead. Avant equal on the Chiefs and items. Now need to actually look to the late game to start to scale again, and Kensi will throw out some bombs on wave clear as best they can, but the Chiefs, I think it has to be Baron here. They need to continue to be proactive.
Yeah, they need to force Avant to come to them now, because it's as much of a mind game as it is an advantage, because all of a sudden, Avant are on the back foot, or they seem to be, and they have to recognize the fact that they still have the wave clear. So you can see they're grouping up. They're willing to wave clear this one out. But if Chiefs are able to force a Baron fight, that might just be enough to tip this game right back in their favor.
And I think the other big pressure point's just been Swiper all game long. He's been in a side lane pushing for so long in this game. He's 50 CS ahead of Porky. He's got his teleport back up. He's level 17 on the Hecarim with over 3,000 health with his Giant's Belt, Merc Treads, with the Home Guard Enchant and his Trinity Force. Swiper's going to wait for Revant to come to him, and he's done such a good job of opening up more space for the Chiefs. I mean, it's been a subtle thing. It's been about a 20-minute investment that he's had to put in for his team, but they found their openings to get ahead. They kept as close as they could in the situation, and the Chiefs, again, just controlling these waves well.
Yeah, so they're able to continue to farm up. It's always the right people absorbing the CS on their lineup, and now all of a sudden, Avant, you see Chelby getting antsy, wanted to pull the trigger on that one. It was just a support player, and they need to make sure that they understand that they can continue to stall this game. They've still got a Ziggs. They've still got a Jinx.
I mean, Porky was holding well, I think, in this 1v1 lane, but I don't quite think it can match up to Swiper at this stage. The Spooks doesn't quite hit. The Chomper's going to clear out a ward. Does miss the last hit, so Avant defend for now. Is Destiny actually going to look through? Chelby might just pull the trigger on the ult. He does, but Spooks, a nice flash to keep himself safe, and they're happy to go back in here. Culling onto Kensi, he has the satchel charge out. Spooks looks for the ulti. Massive grab onto Warble after the Gragas ultimate. He does flash away there, but now Destiny's going to get caught out. Swiper's TP'd around the back. Warble should go down, and does there as Swiper pops his ultimate. And there's just no one left here for Avant. They've lost Kensi as well. Chelby's going to go down, and the Chiefs will dive the turret in. A double kill there coming through for Swiffer. And that's four clean kills as the turret goes down as well.
Yeah, and I really don't understand why Avant are trying to fight this lineup not in lanes, because they have such a good wave clear composition. In the end, Chiefs making them pay. They're going to break the base.
I think Warble just never expected to die in that spot, but that was one hell of a highlight reel as far as clips go. He Gragas stole everyone away just as the hook landed in, and Ejim nailed Jinx with it.
Yeah, he certainly did. Was able to get the priority target, and all of a sudden the Chiefs making a beeline for that Baron. That's probably Avant making one too many mistakes in this game, and the Chiefs looking better than ever at the start of this OPL split.
Yeah, they're going to be 10,000 gold ahead here in the trend of the Chiefs. Losing early but winning when it really counts might be their story here coming through. Against teams that tighten up or against better teams, they'll get punished for this sort of play, but looks to be 2-2 where they'll fall behind in the early stages of the game and just bring it back with their experience.
Yeah, exactly right. Really credit to Swiper in this game. Really has been that pressure point that we're talking about. 3-1-7. He's got 303 CS. He's an absolute huge pony. Maybe not as big as Minky Wales, but he's getting pretty damn big. And, you know, on a new champion in the mid lane, Swiffer showing that he's still probably got Kensi's measure, 4-3-2, but he's done so much damage. He's got the perfect hex score coming through. He's got a void staff now. He's just going to be doing work in these team fights.
I mean, credit to the utility joy here for Chiefs here. A lot of these team fights have been, you know, Ejim's strong playmaking presence and Spook's decent ultis, but it's just Chiefs using their tools well here. Whether it's a good Swiper ultimate or that ridiculous Gragas ult into Nautilus hook that we just saw as well. We talk about Jinx, one of her big flaws. She's very immobile, even with all this peel and zone control that Avant have. You can't stop Hecarim, and you certainly can't stop Gragas ult Nautilus hook.
Yeah, and I'd love to see that again, because I want to know who flashed away, because if it's Sejuani or Alistair, I'm really mad right now if I'm Warble, because I don't have the ability to get away like you guys do, even without the inherent taking.
Well, they're going
to
push in instead. The Baron up minions are coming through, and Spook's going to zone them out. Swiper applying pressure on the bottom side of the map as well. Yeah, tower's not lasting very long at this stage, though, because the Chiefs, with the Baron power up, just melting through structures.
Yeah, you close your eyes. All of a sudden, Radia has four items going to be able to get in here, and all of a sudden, oh, the
Yeah, Chelby threw the ulti, but that did not hit Radia, and I think that creep may have eaten the worst of the ulti as he dusts off the ice from his cannon and continues firing away. Probably should be blocking for the cannon mini, but Kensi, all right, going to clear it out instead. No banner of command to really power up that guy. But Swiper keeps going here on the tower. We'll just take it out. Actually ignoring Porky at this stage. Destiny's coming down. Jovi's forced to come through as well, but she's just too much pressure. Kensi just gets deleted there as Ejim will go down as the trade, but it's two for one. Sorry, as Ian Hib goes down. Chelby dives back in onto Radio. Ulti, though, blocked by Spook. Chelby getting kited out. Massive damage there as Radio kites away from Porky. Swiper now going to dive in onto Wobble. Spook's the next one coming through. Swiffer just puts a laser through him as Spooks takes out the kill. And that's 4-1. Destiny locked up. Gonna make it the fifth as Swiffer gets the triple kill. And the Chiefs, they've done it.
Yeah, Chiefs able to pick up their second win of the season. Little bit shakier than their first, but in the end, it's the results that count. They fight back from behind and really crush through the last 10 minutes of the game.
Yeah, finish undefeated in week one once again at the start of their OPL split here. But shaky is the right word there. I mean, the Chiefs showing off fantastic team fighting and team play. Just, again, lots of veteran shot calling. And all these, you know, cool heads coming together, able to make the calls when it counts. But I'm worried for the Chiefs because that's week one. You probably expected to come in and do quite well. Falling behind against two different teams early, one that wasn't even in the OPL last season, the one that you probably wouldn't have been worried about in split number one. If the Chiefs continue staying where they are, which is a very high level, but everyone else improves, they're going to start losing games.
Yeah, it's funny. I actually think Sin and AV are the second and third best team in the comp. So I give them a little bit more credit. So I think that that's actually the toughest competition they have. They're also integrating Ejim into their team, brand new player. And you said something there that I thought we'd never say. Cool, calm, and collected. They fell behind. No signs of angst in the Chiefs. They really did shot call that game out well.
They did. We actually have a replay from that last game as well. And it is the juicy Gragas Ultimate.
Yeah, so I get to see it. So as we roll this one out, you want to see who flashes to sacrifice Warble. All of a sudden, it's Chelby. It's Kensi. Actually, no one flashed.
I told you.
Chelby was just on the wrong side of it. That should have been him that got grabbed. Instead, Warble gets deleted. Swiper comes in. And from there, even with a good Rumble Ultimate, Porky's like, I'm peacing out of this because Raid is going nuts. Swift is going nuts. I'm not surviving in there, even if you guys want me to fight. And the Chiefs ran over the game from that point.
Yeah, I don't know how planned that was, but the fact that Ejim flushed over a water hook right at the moment where Spooks knocked everyone else away, hard to say how much they've been refining their team play, but that was pretty ridiculous as far as combos go.
Yeah, it was very nice to watch, and this is a combo that we were really happy to see play the Swiffer Spooks as well as Ejim now with some very good Radiant and Swiper. I can't even call them support staff because they're carries in their own right. But yeah, the Chiefs look very scary this season.
They do. And with that, Chiefs pick up a win. We're going to check into the results of the day to see who else managed to pick up victories in day number two. Absolute actually getting their first win on the board as Legacy took out the Direwolves.
Yeah, and then Sin moved in for their first win, going 1-1 in the week one. And the Chiefs knock off Avant to close out the week 2-0.
Yeah, looking strong there. And of course, if you want to check out some of those matches again, check out day one. Or if you just need some results or schedules, get over to that website there, oce.lolesports.com. For all your OPL needs.
Yeah, exactly right. And that has been a really action-packed week one. I honestly, there were some confusing matchups in there. I'm happy to say that Sin is what I expected coming in. I'm also really pleased that Porky behind Avant-Garde is really driving that team forward. And I think we have a really equal contest.
I mean, OPL was pretty great in the last split as far as just level of play goes. For the first split of, you know, the Pro League in Oceania, we saw some great stuff there. Split 2 is warming up to be even better than that. And that's just in week one.
Yeah, it certainly is looking like it's going to be really heavy at the top.
Yeah, looking great there. But with that, we close out our first week of OPL play. So for myself, Spawn, Atlas, Rusty, and our entire live production crew, we'll see you back for more OPL on Monday.